This is actually very pertinent coming from someone like me who essentially has to breathe in data day in and day out. I've seen people sort of use data horribly, right? They'll say, and this is both from client perspectives and internal perspectives, that there are people who love crunching numbers. Okay? And then because digital gives you so much data, it is very, very easy to get lost in it. Okay? Like you can make like a bajillion cuts of your data, right? You can say, okay, I have 10 SKUs that I'm promoting for my campaign. I showed this to 4 different target audiences on 6 different platforms. Let me analyze everything and let me give you my channel specific, SKU specific audience data. It sounds like a great initiative, and people think, oh, it's like this is so much work that you've done and great. But most of the time, this will not give you too much insight, to be very honest, right? So you have to be extremely cautious of what cuts are important to you, and then analyze only those cuts, right? Don't go into the rabbit hole of having like a billion cuts, right? And this is true for DCO campaigns especially, right? I don't know if you heard of DCO campaigns, but DCO campaigns run into creatives into 100,000s, right? We've run campaigns with 250,000 creatives, right? And each creator has 20 different variables that I can control. So imagine the report that comes out of this, right? And imagine if I sit and actually analyze this, I would never be able to take any other campaign live ever. So in that brief, when you make out the brief, figure out the KPIs that you want to look at, and then focus only on data cuts for that. That's important to you. All right. So I think, that's one thing that you should keep track of. Another way of using the sort of same, it's using data wisely, is I've noticed a lot of people who, whatever platform they're from, they only focus on that. Okay, for example, if you are from the paid team, you'll probably only look at Facebook data. Okay, you ran a campaign, you'll only look at Facebook data. Someone from the performance content or the SEO team, they look at only SEO data. And the creative team will look only at carousel chala ke gif chala. All right. There's no one actually who sits and figures out, okay, theek hai, can we cross-utilize this data? Okay, and I'll give you a couple of examples. We ran this campaign for Kotak, I think, all right, where we, after the campaign was on, we actually analyzed the leads that came into us, and we realized that, all right, there is a way that we can make this better. We can deliver higher quality leads, right? Because we noticed that a lot of people who the leads that we called up, they didn't have their Aadhaar card, right? And that's like a mandatory thing to open a bank account whenever it sort of, this was a new rule then, I think about 4 or 5 years back. So what we did was we sort of went back to the landing page, we tweaked the form that we had, and we tweaked the thank you page to say that we'll call you in X amount of time, please have your Aadhaar card handy. That itself like gave us 20% higher qualified leads, right? And then if there was no one sort of sitting and doing this, you would have never realized this, because PayTM is like, haan, TK, bounce rate kitna hai, CTR kitna hai, great, great, very nice. The UI team is like, acha, TK, the form is been filled out perfectly, great, great. And then the SEO team is happy because time on site is great. But then if no one is looking for these small connections, then you won't be able to drive real value for your clients, right? And that's essentially what digital is promising to deliver. And I'll give you one more example. We sort of sat down and looked at the traffic data for Club Mahindra. Okay, so at one point we owned their website and their paid campaigns and the programmatic campaigns and everything essentially. And we also had CRM data. So what we did for that, the creative team sat with the SEO team, and we sort of just went through all the data, and then we saw where the traffic is going for. We saw navigation paths. And then we realized that there are a few properties that get a lot of traffic, right? Even if right now, if you've heard of Club Mahindra, you know the 2 or 3 properties I'm speaking about, right? It's probably you heard of Munnar, you've probably heard of Coorg, you've probably heard of Varka Goa. But then they have like 60 different properties that people don't visit at all, okay? So then we went back to the line and said, let's run an awareness campaign. And the only properties we focused on are the ones that are not getting traffic at all, which sounds absolutely counterintuitive, is that you're trying to promote properties that are not giving you the ROI or the returns, right? But what happened was this let us sort of expand their upper funnel, where now people knew more about their properties, which was insane, and it worked really well for us. So always think of how you can use this data really, really well to sort of cross promote. Always keep testing, right? And this is like, I think there are two mantras that I use with my team. This is one of them, and we'll come on the second one, I think, after this, all right? And I know there's a lot of people who may be in paid or are sort of paid in trend. They're like, haha, I always test new landing pages and here and go. But I've been testing every single thing, right? Testing in performance content, testing on social, testing on paid, testing landing pages, testing your website, all of it, right? Because unfortunately, digital is not, even though all the agencies are set up like this, where we have a paid team, we have an SEO team, we have a blah team, that is not actually how digital works, right? And if you sometimes sit and look at the data, if you have a data science team or if you know a data person who's worked in digital, you ask them, whenever they've tried mapping a single user's journey or whatever, right? It's not a linear journey. Like Google Analytics makes it very simple, where it's like, oh, achha, this is my funnel. Step one, step two, step three, step four. But if you actually look at the data, you download GAK dump, the cookie dump that they have. And if you actually sort of go through that data, if you know data, it's weird. Like people will enter on step one on the funnel, then they'll see an ad, they'll land on step four, then they'll come to step two, and then they'll sign out, and then they'll see a TVC ad, or someone will call them, and then in the end they'll sort of convert, right? And then there is no way you can track any of this or make any head or sense of what's happening, right? So the only way you can do this is you keep testing different things, and then see what works for you, what doesn't work for you, okay? And when I say testing everything. You test the creatives that you run, you test the audiences that you run, you test campaign structures, you test account keywords, you test RSA headlines, you test different combinations of RSA headlines, try juggling the ad keywords in your ad group, try juggling event calendars for performance content, try out random things in your blog, okay? But the only thing I wanted to remember is don't do random testing. KRAR, I heard Nimit Nebula, I got inspired, I'm going to test, and just test random things and just do todafod in your campaign, right? There has to be a structure to this. Approach it very, very smartly, right? You need to know why you're testing something. For example, if you're changing a creative, you need to answer the question, why am I changing the creative? And by changing this creative, what is the metric that I hope to change? And that metric can only be a single metric, either secondary, tertiary, nahi aa sakta hai, right? So if you are absolutely sure that I want to change this creative to increase CTR, then the creative team knows that okay, maybe like a nice high contrast saturated creative that grabs attention, usse CTR mera badh jayega. But if you are doing this for pushing up the number of quality leads that you have, then maybe you'll be more copy focused in your creative or your ads that you write or the landing page that you send people to, okay? So always know why you're testing something, and by testing that, what is the metric you hope to increase, right? Don't do random tests. But yeah, always keep testing new things. Even if you think your account is doing great, I promise you it can be better. There is no end to optimization. And that in one way is the beauty and the ugliness of digital, is that you don't know when to stop.